அழித்திடவும் ஒருக்கிடவும் இரட்டிடவும் நீ ஆழ்வாய் கரைத்திடும் ஆட்டினில் வாழ்கின்ற மன குரங்கு காட்டினின் குரங்கெல்லாமும் கூட்டினில் நீ விரட்டி குணமாயறிந்து நீயும் விரிந்து நீ பாரடா மனமே நீ வீதங்களை கூறாடா தினமே அறிந்து நீ பாரடம் அன்றை அதை ஆராய்ந்து கொள்ளடா விரிந்து நீ ஆடடா அங்கு அந்த விதங்களோடு பாடடா மனமே நல்ல வழிக்கிதுமாகும் மனம் நாட்டிலேயே வழி கூடும் உண்மையோடு மனம் நீயும் உறவாடடாய
Assalamu alaikum. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Sometimes we wonder why we're having so many difficulties in our life, or why the people that are close to us are having so many difficulties in their lives, why there is so little peace in our lives, and so little peace in the lives of those people around us. These are great questions for us. If we can't answer these questions, if they remain a riddle to us, then we have a tendency to lose faith. We lose faith in ourselves, we lose faith in our religions, and we lose faith in God. The problem is when we lose this kind of faith, we also lose the value of the lessons that go along with the experiences that we're having in our life. We lose the connection to the very wisdom within us, which can provide the answers. What God is showing us is a number of situations in our life that have something to teach us. And when we have that intention for God, that inner, deep intention for the love and the unity and the surrender to God, then the lessons become very clear because they're brought to us on the screen of our own wisdom. God gives us that screen of wisdom and shows us the meanings of the lessons of the situations of our life. And then that brings the unity to our heart, and then we have the unity and the peace with all people around us. This film that you're about to see will answer the questions of why we're having these problems in our life. I think that you will gain a great deal out of it. Thank you.
This is about
the sorrows.
The sorrows that man feels. Among all the creations in this world, human beings feel sorrow and grief in all their lives, whether he thinks it is joy or sorrow, whether it is success or failure. God has created countless numbers, countless varieties of beings, and countless varieties of lives dwell in this world. There are birds, there are reptiles and animals. There are lives in the water, there are lives that live in fire, on earth, in the sky, in the wind. All these were created by God. And having created all these, all those other lives, they live in peace, satisfied. But as far as peace is concerned, the lowest in the level of peace is mankind. So man is really the lowest of all beings. Oh, as far as number is concerned, human beings are the least in creation. compared to fish and birds and animals.
Minority.
So the human beings are truly a minority in this world of God's creation.
Majority.
The other creations are in the vast majority.
அவ்வளவு படைப்புகளும் இருந்தும்
even though there is such a vast number among all the other creations. 20
முட்டையிடும் 20 குஞ்சுகள்
Take a chicken.
Or நாய்
When it lays eggs, it lays 20 eggs, so that 20 chickens. A dog will litter 8 puppies. A pig, a sow, 16.
இப்படி பெருகியே அதுகளுக்கு கஷ்டம் இருக்க இல்ல.
And even though they are multiplying at such a fast rate, they do not experience any difficulties in this world. A fish lays its eggs. And when they hatch, there are thousands of little ones. But even though there are such a large majority, they do not suffer any difficulties on account of their numbers. Even though they multiply so fast, they live their life in peace. But human beings, they were only one child at a time. And if 1,001 are born, let's say 1,000 may die. Only one is left. Birth and death seem to go parallel. So the increase in numbers is maybe one at a time. But see how all the other creations multiply so rapidly. They are born, they die, but their numbers multiply so fast. Without any real limit. But in spite of the vast numbers and the fast multiplication, they live their life in peace and satisfied, contented. Man alone is not contented with his life. He goes around grumbling and shouting and saying, why was I born like this? He says, there is no God, why should I suffer if I was born like this? All the grumbling, all the complaining is only by human beings. Not even a majority population among the creations of the world. Human beings are in a very small minority. But still, they find so much difficulty. Now look at the snakes. They are able to fashion a house for themselves. The birds have their own nests, cows and goats and horses, donkeys, animals that live in the jungle, they fashion some sort of dwelling place for themselves, whether it is rain or sun, storm or gale. They don't worry too much about it because they live with their faith in God. The animals live for the day. They look after their food for each moment. But why do human beings find it so difficult? It is because one man attacks another, hurts another to survive. It is because human beings have this quality of attacking or hurting another. One person might deceive another, trick another, one person might feel envious or jealous about another, he may be treacherous to another. And it is because of these evil qualities that harm, tend to hurt another, that are the cause of his suffering, because whatever evil intention he has towards another, those same evil intentions go back and attack him. Whatever weapons he aims at another, will really harm him at the end. It is these kind of thoughts directed towards hurting another that come back to hurt himself. And this is the reason why man is being gone so low in the level of lives. All his thoughts, all his jealousies, his anger, all tending to hurt another, to ruin another person's life, to destroy another man's house, or to ruin another man's job. Whatever his action may be, it is directed towards ruining another person. And this is the reason why human beings find it so hard.
துன்பம் கொடுக்கிறது மனிதனே மனிதனை கொல்லுகின்றதனால் தான் மனிதனே மனிதன் வாட்டுகிறனால்
It is human beings who tend to hurt another, trying to kill another, try to be treacherous towards another, that bring the level of mankind so low in the level of God's creations. So he goes on complaining and shouting right unto his death. He says, oh, this is a horrible life, and he continues to shout until his death. What is the reason for this? He is trying to accumulate things in his life.
மனிதன் இருக்கும் இடமும்
while all the other lives live contented and peaceful the place where man lives his dwelling place and wherever they
உயிர்களுக்கு சாந்தியும் இல்லாம இருக்கும் மனிதனே ஒருவன்தான்
man other lives don't have any peace wherever human beings get together
உயிர்களுக்கு சாந்தி இருக்க இல்ல சாந்தி கொடுக்கிறதுக்கு என்னாதுகளுக்கு
Man has no intention of leaving other lives in peace. He has only his own intention is to kill others. Human beings grow up in this way, tending to hurt or harm other human beings or other lives. It is this mentality that causes the suffering to man. That is his hell. He is burning throughout his life. And therefore he knows no peace.
இதனால் இறைவன் குற்றமோ அல்லது இறைவன் குற்றமோ
The fact that human beings are suffering like this does not mean that it is the fault of God, the one who created him. It is only man, the way that man conducts his own life, man's thoughts in his life that is responsible, his words. His actions, the way he conducts himself, are responsible for his own suffering. The only trouble is that because of his actions, even the good people, the good ones, may be hurt by his thoughts. See, if a forest fire starts, it blazes along and even the good trees might get caught in that fire. God somehow will protect the good ones, even though they are in the midst of that fire. My love you, my precious children. Therefore, it is these thoughts within us that we must transform into good thoughts, our actions into good actions in our life. It is our responsibility to transform, to change our own lives. It is we who have to fashion our lives, whatever we may do. We have to draw up a plan to change our thoughts and our hearts. Even if you want to build a house, you have to have a plan the way you want to build it. And just as you have a point towards which you direct your actions, your life too, you must have a plan to. You must draw up how, in what way you are going to transform your life. Your actions, your thoughts, our words, our actions, our conduct, we must transform them and fashion them in the right way, in a good manner. And is that plan that is going to give us, make it an exalted life? So we must bring it to a state which will, from which we will derive peace, contentness and tranquility. You cannot wait for heaven to derive that peace. You have to do it here. If you want wealth, it is the wealth of your love that you must accumulate within this kalp. It is your thoughts, the mind which must be changed. Your love and your beautiful qualities will be your treasures and you have to do them here. It is only when you make God qualities come into you that they will be your wealth. Your peace and your tranquility, these will be your treasures. For all the time that you don't understand this, all the time you don't fashion this within you, no matter how many births, how many millions of births we may take, You will never succeed in attaining peace in your life.
துன்பம் போக மாட்டார்.
And the suffering will not be dispelled. Your karma cannot be dispelled.
நரகம் என்கிற நெருப்பு சூழ்ந்து எரிந்து கொண்டே இருக்கும்.
So throughout our life, the fire that is called hell will be burning, surrounding us all the time.
நரகமும் புறாமையும் அசதும் வஞ்சமும் ஒவ்வொரு குணங்களில்
எவ்ரி குவாலிட்டி எவ்ரி ஈவில் குவாலிட்டி லைக் எங்கர் ஹேஸ்டினஸ் ட்ரெச்சரி என்வி தீஸ் ஆர் த குவாலிட்டி தட் வில் கீப் அஸ் சரவுண்டட் எவ்ரி தாட் ஆஃப் திஸ் நேச்சர் தட் வி திங்க் வில் கம் ரவுண்ட் டு சரவுண்ட் அஸ் அண்ட் ஹர்ட் அஸ்
நீங்கள் அறிவாலயத்தை அமைச்சு
மை லவ் யூ மை சில்ட்ரன் யூ மஸ்ட் ஃபேஷன் திஸ்
இது உங்களாலே அமைச்சுக்கொள்ள வேண்டுமே தவிர
அண்ட் ட்ரான்ஸ்ஃபார்ம் யுவர் செல்ஃப் இன்டு தட் ஸ்டேட் இதயத்தில் அமைச்சு இட் இஸ் யூ ஹூ ஹஸ் டு டு திஸ் நோபடி எல்ஸ் கேன் கம் அண்ட் டு இட் ஃபார் யூ இன் யுவர் லைஃப்
ஒரு அறிவாளி உங்களுக்கு சில காரணத்தை எடுத்து காட்டி அறிவை போதிப்பார் தவிர
a man of wisdom can only explain this to you and tell you what has to be done but he cannot do it for you. A teacher can teach you the alphabet A B C D but when the words have to be formed it is you who have to join these letters to form the words.
அதிலிருந்து உங்க அமைப்பை நீங்க தான் கூட்டிக்கொள்ளும்.
In the same way the Quran which was, comes from the 28 letters can be explained to you but it is you who have to take the meaning. So the Sheikh can explain these things to you but transforming your qualities inside you into God's qualities, God's actions without the slightest doubt to take them into your heart and to fashion them into the good quality, that has to be done only by you. But all the time that you have not succeeded in bringing that into action, into your heart, you can never hope to attain peace. That beauty will not appear in your heart. That radiance will not appear in your face and there will not be that clarity in your life. There will be no taste in the food or the drink that you take in. And when you look in your eyes, the look in your eyes will not carry any compassion. There will not be that love in the clarity of your look. In this way, my children, you must understand. Only when you bring these qualities into action in your heart that you will know that completeness, that treasure and the happiness in that life through that patience, contentment, surrender to
Allah.
We must reflect on this. I love you, my precious children, jewel lights of my eyes. You have to change your hearts into that state. But there are two halves now, two sections, your mind, If you can transform yourself into this state, your mind will turn into a honeybee which will go only in search of beautiful flowers. And you will go in search of that beauty and take only the honey and the pollen and bring it back to you, the good thing. In the same way, it will bring back to you His grace, His treasures, His qualities, His wisdom and gather them to you. Your wisdom will go out and bring all these things, the good things to you. Having accumulated these things, it will display that taste to you and bring you that peace.
But
as long as you have not brought that state into action within you through your wisdom, your mind will become a fly. One time it became a honeybee and went in search of tasty honey. But when it turns into a fly, it will go in search of feces. It goes, enters into that pore of Maya
and
look for the stench and the stink of rotten things and the feces and the urine. So the mind could change this way or that. You must reflect on this and see. The same mind, if it turns to the left side, it will go only in search of hell. If it turns to the right side, it will go in search of the beautiful flowers, the fragrant flowers and the honey. And for both of these, whichever it may be, you are the cause. You are the one who will decide what you are going to be. My love, you, my precious children, you must reflect on this. If you turn to the left, you will take the form of the fly going in search of feces and stench. Not only will it search for those things, there also, there is that. It has that equality, but the equality for all things dirty. It looks on all dirty things equally. That doesn't mean that that fly is devoid of discrimination. The fact that it goes and sits on everything dirty without any discrimination doesn't mean that it shows equality to all things. It gets brings the dirty things and then goes and sits on good things and dirty is the good things too. The honeybee does not go in search of things dirty or bad smells. It goes on the beautiful flower and draws that honey gently without hurting the flower. These actions which stem from ignorance searching for dirty things, you might say that the fly treats them all equally. The honeybee shows equality, shows without preference. It goes on, sits on all beautiful flowers alike. But one, the honeybee brings you peace. The fly gives you hell. So you must turn your mind to the right, like the honeybee. But it's also capable of turning to the left. So when you find it trying to turn to the left side, you must give it a sharp rap and turn it round, turn it to the right like the honeybee. If you find it looking to the left, give it a tap with your wisdom and turn him around. If you fail to do this, the fly will keep going on to the left side. In the journey of your life, your wisdom must be the like the whip, controlling the mind. Turn your life to the right side. Whenever the mind seems to want to turn to the left, give it a swish and make it turn to the left. Each time you try to turn to the left, turn it round. In this way, if you can keep correcting it, changing its direction every time it tries to turn to the left, then alone will you find that peace in your life. You are the travelers on the journey of this of your life. And wisdom must be the one who is driving you along. So may you transform your lives. If you do this with your wisdom and your faith, only then can you find that peace in your life. Your qualities and your actions must be changed. Every word that your sheikh gives you will be words of truth. If you reflect on them deeply, adapt them to your life. But if you experience doubts, if you fail to grasp what he says, if you disagree, then you will have no hopes. You will turn into the fly, you will go on the left for the dirty things and hell will be your portion. You will not know the other side at all and therefore you will never know any peace because you will go for the rotten, decaying things. The mind has the potential to turn to either side. You must try to turn it to the side where there is honey. That is God's portion. If you don't succeed in turning it to the right, to the honey, then the fly, like the fly, you will creep into Maya. And then you will search for all the dirty things. So you must think of these two things. How you can control it, how you can turn it to the right. And be very vigilant every time it tries to turn to the left. Be aware of it and turn it quickly. So at every moment, you have to be vigilant, attentive, and turn it around every time. Always try to turn your mind to the good side at every moment. Only then will you find mastery in your life and peace and tranquility, and then you will receive the wealth of God, success in your life in this path towards God. Then you will know that state of happiness. May you reflect on this and observe your life carefully. Observe the mind carefully. Turn it around every time.
Amen.
Assalamu alaikum. So you can see that this learning, this kind of teaching, is coming from the highest place in our hearts. This is a path of the heart. It's not a path of the mind or the intellect. We have to be like that honeybee. We have to extract the wisdom from our life, from the events of our life, from the everyday events of our life. We have to take that wisdom and bring it in into our hearts and transform it into love and peace, because that's what will nurture people and give people peace themselves, so that people will naturally see that kind of peace and where it's coming from. Or we can choose to be like the fly and just take the junk from the world and extract the anger and the bitterness and the divisiveness and feed that to our heart. But the problem is that those qualities don't give any nurturance to either ourselves or to other people. So let's be just like that bee, coming from the highest possible point of God's wisdom, so that we can share that with other people. For more information, if you want more information about the fellowship and this kind of teaching, contact the nearest Bawal Mahayadeen Fellowship. Assalamu alaikum.